South Korea could reach a major milestone in space exploration soon. After more than 6 years of perfecting its design and trajectory, Danuri is ready for launch. Shin Ye-eun introduces to us the lunar orbiter KPLO.
This year, South Korea will join one of humanity's greatest races ever, the space race. And it's all thanks to the KPLO, short for Korea Pathfinder Lunar Orbiter. In 2016, the Korea Aerospace Research Institute, also known as KARI, started developing a spacecraft that has recently been named Danuri. It's a combination of two Korean words, Dal and Nuri, short for moon and enjoy.
The KPLO will travel to the moon by taking a boomerang-shaped trajectory. This flight method is known as BLT, ballistic lunar transfer. Though it will travel farther than any other orbiter during past missions, it will maximize fuel economy because it moves using the gravitational force of the sun, moon, and Earth. And the KPLO aims to reach orbit 100 kilometers above the lunar surface by late December this year, from where it will conduct a range of studies. Data will be collected from the moon using six instruments on Danuri. One of them is the shadow cam, provided by NASA, which will investigate what's known to be shadow regions of the moon to check for resources like water or ice. A pole cam and LUDI, short for Lunar Terrain Imager, will also be attached. This acts as Danuri's eyes on the moon, providing high-resolution images of the moon's surface. The magnetic strength of the moon will be measured using a KPLO magnometer, while a gamma-ray spectrometer will also be used to analyze lunar topography. Lastly, a DTNPL device. You can think of this as an internet communication device or space Wi-Fi. This will switch on. Now let's take a listen to what KARI has to say are the determinants of success for the KPLO mission.
There are three key points that will determine whether the KPLO mission is successful. Firstly, whether Danuri separates from the rocket it's attached to at the exact position needed for the BLT method. Secondly, if Danuri can enter lunar orbit at an altitude of 100 kilometers by December 16th this year. It has to be punctual because if it's a bit late, it may collide with other countries' orbiters. Finally, we must be able to collect all the data we need using six of the instruments aboard Danuri.
Danuri hopes to carry out research until December 2023. This includes identifying potential landing sites for future lunar missions, as well as the search for usable resources on the moon.
The Korea Aerospace Research Institute is going through its final checks before sending off Danuri to an Air Force base in Florida. Danuri will then blast off in early August aboard a Falcon 9 rocket made by SpaceX. If successful, Korea would be the seventh country in the world to reach the lunar orbit. Shin Ye-eun, Arirang News.